New Jersey time. It's 11:43. Hi, everybody. It's Big Joe Henry playing the hits today. All weekend, we're in Asbury Park at Convention Hall celebrating the 5th annual Asbury Park Music and Film Festival. So many great events. And with me, two of my favorite guys. They're with me every year. They're both members of the board of the film festival and co-chairs of the event. With me, he is the co-president and co-founder of Sony Pictures Classics. He's been nominated, Sony Picture Classic nominated, get a load of this, for over 143 Academy Awards, resulting in 35 Academy Award winnings. How about that? He is a very talented movie guru and sensei, our good friend Tom Bernard, ladies and gentlemen. There's Tom Bernard.
Joe, thanks, Joe.
And with Tom is another Tom, lots of Toms here today. He's the president and publisher of Gannett's Asbury Park Press and other Northeast properties. He's on the board of the Asbury Park Music and Film Festival and the Asbury Park Music Foundation. He was Asbury Park's Grand Marshal in last year's parade, and he's given so much back to New Jersey and the community, and I'm so glad he's with me. Ladies and gentlemen, my man, Tom Donovan. Hi, Tom.
Hey, Joe, thanks.
Guys, I'll tell you what, and I say this to you every year, it's the 5th annual. This festival gets better and better. It has a tremendous amount of talent here, and I don't know how you guys pull it off, but it's amazing. Tom Bernard, you've got a great thing happening. We're kicking off the David Crosby, What's My Name, that's happening. To tell me a little bit about that.
Well, first off, hats off to the people who own Convention Hall putting a projector in the Paramount Theater after 50 years.
Yeah. How about that, right?
How about that? I think the last movie I saw there was Sound of Music. Anyway, so what we have is we've got a David Crosby movie, Can't Remember My Name, and it's the story of David's life. If you liked rock music, if you were into classic rock, which was rock at the time,
yeah,
this movie gives you a river through his life. And you'll find out and you'll connect at the moment you remember hearing that music, and you'll say to yourself, I didn't know those things.
Yeah.
If you were an 18-year-old, you said, my parents, I got like a, holy crap, look what happened to this guy. It's unbelievable. It's David is there being sort of brought through everything by Cameron Crowe. He's the voice off camera. You'll see David, he's at Kent State where yeah, the guys were killed. What does he do? He talks about where Neil Young wrote Four Dead in Ohio. He's driving down the street in Sunset Boulevard, and he points to, oh, there's the Troubadour Club. He tells a story about the Troubadour Club. Then you see the movie of it. Then you see the headlines, and you hear the story. So you're sort of living all the things, the beginning of the Byrds, the beginning of Crosby, Stills, and Nash, the end of Crosby, Stills, and Nash. David, right now, he opens the movie. He says, you know, I got 8 stents in my heart. I got a new liver, and I'm diabetic. I don't know why I'm alive. 77 years old.
Well,
he unfolds from that.
And you're going to show the movie, but then he's going to be here.
David's going to be here, and
Cameron Crowe
is going to interview David. It's going to be like an extension of the movie on the stage, which is going to be incredible. And they're filming it, too. So
And that is at 7 o'clock
right,
tonight.
Mm-hmm.
So you still have time to get tickets. You can go to apmff.org or come down here and get them right away. And because that's probably going to sell out.
Right. And Cameron and David have never done this. I mean, this movie's played only a couple of places in the world, and this is the first time they'll be talking about it on stage.
Wow, it's great. Tom Donovan, we've got some great music tonight at the Stone Pony. Is the Tangiers Blues Band with Danny Clinch. And you and I have seen them many times, and I'm such a big fan of that.
Yeah, I love Danny Clinch and that band. They are something special. They're here every single year, giving their time and talents. And if you don't have your tickets for that show tonight, go get them now.
Yeah.
It'll be the Tangiers Blues Band featuring Danny Clinch, our own Danny Clinch. He's one of our co-chairs of this festival.
That's right.
And many, many special guests. So get ready for one fun time tonight down at the Stone Pony.
We kicked it off last night with Joe Krasicki and Gary U.S. Bonds. And it's just the energy of the people here at the festival is tremendous. What I love about you guys is that is where the funds go to. Talk about a little bit of the programs that where the Asbury Park Music Foundation.
Yeah, our festival is one of a kind. All the proceeds go to the Asbury Park Music Foundation. And the foundation runs a number of programs for the underserved youth of Asbury Park in the surrounding area. Our newest addition, and we're very proud of it, is our Beat Bus, which you're familiar with. It's outside of the theater here. I encourage everybody to stop in and check it out. It's literally a mobile recording studio on wheels. We go to the kids around the great state of New Jersey. We go to after-school programs, boys and girls clubs. And we've served over 3,000 kids in the last year, which is just amazing. And we're very proud of that bus, Joe.
Well, it's phenomenal. And you know, Tom, both times, the first thing that's cut usually in school programs is the arts and the music and the film. And this giving money back into this area is such a necessity for those that need. And the great thing about the Beat Bus is, you know, kids can't have transportation to go to something like that. So that bus goes to them. And I think that's a phenomenal thing.
Yeah, that bus actually has, I think, 15 mixing stations on there. And the kids learn how to mix their own records, their own music. And so they've always got somebody who's a little more important than them on there, sort of encouraging them and showing them. And every time I've talked to somebody, they say, this guy mixed it better than I could have.
Yeah. Well, listen, we've got there's a lot of great things happening on Sunday, too. And come down here, and Tom Jones will be down here in a little bit to talk about his movie tomorrow, the Asbury Park Riot, Redemption, Rock and Roll. And there's a lot of great things happening. The Bruce Springsteen Archives is going to happen later on this afternoon.
Yep.
Followed by a big Q&A, never-be-seen footage. There's great stuff going at the House of Independence and music at the Stone Pony, music at the Wonder Bar, and a lot of other stuff.
Let me throw a couple of things at you. Okay, one of the things that I think is everybody who's anybody in the music business shows up at this event. Bob Dylan's manager, Jeff Rosen, is on our board. I said, Jeff, would you like to be on the board? He said, sure. I never want to come to a meeting, but I'll do something special for you. So he goes to the Dylan Archives in Tulsa, Oklahoma, and he pulls 15 songs that nobody's ever seen unless you were in the crowd that day, and then shows them at the House of Independence and sits in the back and introduces and sets the scene for every song. And there are things that'll just blow your mind. That's amazing. And then the other thing that's amazing is we have Mike Fleming, who's the editor of Deadline Hollywood, the biggest paper in the trades, coming down to interview the Farrelly Brothers. And the Farrelly Brothers are living their dream. They love Asbury Park. They've never been here. And they're going to be at the Stone Pony being interviewed about all their movies and all their lives. I mean, the kind of little stories they have. They're in Dumb and Dumber when the guy gets his tongue stuck on the pole. You know, they say, "Oh, I said, Pete, how'd you come up with that?" He said, "Oh, my friend Joey, that happened to him when he was 12. So you're going
to
hear all the behind the scenes.
Get over to apmff.org and have some fun and do it. Ladies and gentlemen, Tom Bernard, Tom Donovan, two instrumental people that make this thing happen at the Asbury Park News. I love you
guys.
Thank you so much. Here's Fast Traffic.